Mike joins us on the line right now. Thanks for making time, Mike.
No problem, Matt.
First question, and it's a tough one, but we got a lot of people who are asking, why hasn't the general manager come out and said, look, I shoulder the blame for this season, put it right here on me?
Well, I took responsibility for how the season went, but, you know, we're all responsible to some measure, players, coaches, managers, but you can rest assured I assume all the responsibility, and the issue with that is that we didn't get the result in the playoffs that we felt we should have gotten over the past 2 years, and it's time for a new voice and a change.
Mike, yesterday you were hesitant to talk to us about the next coach. You said you needed some time and very much understand that you wanted to show respect to Alain Vigneault yesterday, but can you fill us in today on what type of coach you'll be looking for?
Well, there's a number of qualified candidates that are out there, and you know, I like to have the team play a certain style of play. I like an upbeat, fast style of play with a quick transition, and yeah, we managed to do that. We were successful, and you know, we're going to look for a new voice, a different type of voice that can resonate with the players and our fans, and that's going to take some time, and it's a process, but there's a number of good qualified candidates.
Does that mean the next coach, Mike, will have to be philosophically aligned with you with regards to offensive hockey? And I guess the second part of that question is, can you still play that way given the way we see the rule book enforced these days?
I think you have to play both ways. You have to be very sound defensively, and you have to be able to score goals. And, you know, you need the full package, and I don't think it's fair to define it as one or the other. I think you need both, and you need to be balanced, and, you know, we're going to strive to get a little bit younger, a little bit bigger, and a little bit more balanced through our lineup. And, you know, it's tough. It's a tough business, and it's tough to make instantaneous changes, but, you know, we felt that after witnessing what's happened the last couple of years in the playoffs, a change was needed in terms of the biggest change we could make, and we're going to continue to try and improve this team and try and execute the plan that we have.
Good day, Mike. Wondering if even a part of you, and it probably would be hard to admit this, would a part of you even be cheering on the Blackhawks to a degree, because they kind of play the style now that I'm sure you would like to see your team playing, yet they find themselves down in the second round of the playoffs?
I think Detroit plays a very similar style, and you know, these trends come and go, and like I said yesterday in the press conference, that the LA Kings were a game away from missing the playoffs, and now suddenly they're the template for everything good in hockey, and I don't think that's the case. I think that you take what you're given, you work with it, you improve it, and you go into every situation with a balanced lineup, and you have a chance to succeed. The common threads for success in the playoffs are great goaltending, a little bit of luck, and having a really good, balanced hockey team. And, you know, 2 years ago we had that. We unfortunately ran into some injuries that hurt us at the end, but, you know, we had a well-balanced team. Because of different circumstances that have occurred, yeah, you know, we lost some of those players, and we lost one player in particular that hurt us, and trying to replace him was difficult. But we still have to play a certain style of game in order to be successful in the playoffs, and, you know, we just didn't see it the last two seasons.
Who's the one player that you felt was missing the most in your team? Were you referring to Manny, or who are you?
Yeah, I think Manny's injury was a really devastating injury for a lot of reasons. He's got great leadership qualities, and he really solidified that third line for us, and provided us with that balance. And, you know, I know some people think that you just go out and replace those kind of guys, but you don't. And, you know, they're not low-hanging fruit that you can grab, and it takes time to replace them, and you have to sometimes replace them within and be patient. But
Did you spend significant time trying to replace or looking for the backup plan to Malhotra in what little time you had in this past offseason prior to the lockout, thinking that he might not last?
Yeah, we did. We tried, but the lockout interrupted a lot of things, mm-hmm. and then as soon as it was over, he hit the ground running, and there were a lot of surprises in the first month of the season, Anaheim being one major surprise in the West. And, you know, the landscape changed for a lot of different teams, and a lot of the discussions we had disappeared because of the changing landscape. So, you know, we were trying, but it was a difficult season to get things done.